This is 77 WABC, the Yola Nash Show. Listen why the world's biggest stars love talking to Yola Nash on WABC Radio, the Yola Nash Show.
I'm so excited to introduce my fantastic guest. He's a master trumpeter, the world's best-selling jazz artist. He has received multiple gold, platinum, and Grammy awards. The one and only, the great Chris BOTTI is here. Chris, welcome to the show.
Well, with an introduction like that, you should be my manager. Thank you very much. It's very nice of you. You have a very exotic voice.
Oh my gosh, your voice is amazing. Chris, when people look at your amazing career today, they may think it's been always like this, but I know that your journey with your music wasn't that shiny, that easy from the beginning, and I've heard that you even played in the subway and on the streets, and could you tell us a little bit about it?
Yeah, I think when you look at other instruments, when you look at violin or piano, there are people called prodigies, and they explode in their teens, and they're gifted. Now, in my lifetime, I've only really known of one prodigy on the trumpet, and that's Wynton Marsalis.
Mm.
Everyone else, the trumpet kind of bestows their talent on you like an opera singer. It just happens in their 30s and their 40s. Like Miles Davis made his best music in his 40s,
mm-hmm.
you know, and that's what happened to me. I didn't really have real stardom or reach people or had the ability to move their emotions till I was in my 40s. Am I grateful for that? Absolutely. Because it's a lot of pressure to be a prodigy. I felt like each step of the way, if I was able to pay my landlord by playing on the street or playing Latin gigs or playing weddings, then I felt like I was winning the Academy Award. So I was never despondent or upset that I wasn't the star at 35 yet, you know, and so I waited and I waited and waited, and I became a star at 42, you know, and that's my path in life, and I'm very proud of it.
Mm-hmm. I was thinking about it because we all have goals and dreams we want to achieve, and I know how determined we have to be, how strong to continue like you did. I admire that so much.
Well, thank you very much. I mean, it's also the trumpet is such a commitment. You know, you make a general pact with yourself to play the trumpet when you're 9 or 10, and it's, you know, 4, 5, 6 hours a day. Regardless of whether you're going to make it or not, you have to play that instrument.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a beautiful torture.
Yes. But you've been playing since you were 9 years old, right?
Yeah. Wow. And I still, even in these days, I still have to play 5 hours a day, you know, and I say beautiful torture because I love it.
I've heard one day you were comparing your routine that you practice every day to some kind of a routine of a ballet dancer, how committed you have to be and how much you have to love the instrument.
It's very, very similar. So if you play the trumpet or you're a ballet dancer, you're sitting on that bar, you know, with the doing, you know, the stuff, the exercises, the calisthenics that the ballet dancers have to do every day. You have to do the thing on trumpet to get the muscles to be elastic,
mm-hmm.
and have focus. It's very physical.
Is it true, Chris, when you were 12 years old, you wrote Chuckman Johnny and you invited him to dinner?
Yeah.
What a story.
And he was a nice guy, wrote me back.
Wow.
And he said, you know, I can't do that, but I can, you know, have you come backstage and meet me. And he was a very lovely person.
What is the secret to your fantastic, impressive career?
I don't know if the secret is luck, but, you know, there's certainly luck involved. And then B is I care deeply about my audience, which sounds cliche, but you'd be surprised how many artists don't care about their audience. They care about themselves. They care about their band. They care about getting paid or whatever that is, but they don't care about their audience. They're not really there to share with their audience. You know, I put my priorities where my mouth is, and I care deeply about my audience, and I do everything for them. So maybe that's one secret.
Mm-hmm. You have an impressive list of artists you have collaborated with, and it includes Sting, Tony Bennett, Lady Gaga, Josh Groban, Michael Bublé, Andrea Bocelli, David Foster. I mean, the list is unbelievable. Is there any artist you are still kind of dreaming of?
Someday, if Peter Gabriel ever wanted to do something, I would be honored. But I'm pretty much done the as many singers as I can. With Sting being at the top, and Sting being, you know, my brother that made my career. He's the guy that, you know, is my family and stood in front of all the things and made the things happen. So it's a very different kind of collaboration with him.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I can imagine. You were also named
one of
the 50 most...
Oh, God, here we go.
50 most beautiful people by People magazine. And how does it make you feel?
Well, it was 15 years ago, and you bringing it up makes me feel old. But thank you. You're very lovely. Thank you.
I will edit the numbers.
Thank you. You're very sweet. Sure. I mean, it was a Sting benefit, and I walked down the red carpet, and then the next day they called and told me that, and Sting had been out the year before, and he teased me about it, and it was very nice.
Is it true you play almost like nonstop, 300 days a year?
We're on the road about 280, 300 days a year, but that includes travel days. So, you know, when you go from Cancun, Mexico to Latvia, and that takes you 2 days.
Mm-hmm.
And then we just had a little thing where we, you know, played the Colosseum in Rome and flew to San Francisco, played a one-nighter and flew on a red-eye to New York that night. You know,
Wow. Wacky
stuff like that. We're always doing, you know, insane travel stuff, always.
Wow.
Because I like it.
Do you have time for anything else? Any other passions?
No.
No.
My personal life is a shell, but those are the priorities that you make in your life. And that, you know, if you have a, you know, if you ever had a chance when you're 9 years old to write what your absolute dream is, as a trumpet player, my dream at 9 years old, which I am living now, is like finding, you know, a needle in three haystacks. That's how. But you have to be good, but you have to be lucky to that point,
mm-hmm,
to find a needle in three haystacks. So I don't have a traditional, you know, like a kid, a wife, a plant, a dog, etc. I live in a hotel in New York. I get it. And it's a really weird life, but look what I get to do. It's just
awesome. Yes.
I feel very, very lucky.
What's a guilty pleasure Chris Botti can confess?
A guilty pleasure that I really am terrible at is chess.
Oh.
All day long. And there's some kid, some 12-year-old from, you know, Mumbai, who's just crushing me, and it's just ticking me off so bad. But that's what I really love. There's a lot of correlation between chess and jazz, and Wynton plays it too.
Oh, yeah, Wynton is really good at it.
Yeah.
Many jazz musicians do play chess. So interesting.
Yeah.
Wow. What can audiences expect from your show here in New Jersey? We can't wait to see you at NJPAC in Newark, New Jersey.
We're going to have the best band I've ever brought on stage. So Caroline Campbell will be there. We have a great new jazz singer. She's 23, up-and-coming, named Veronica Swift. She's awesome. Then we have Cy Smith, who's been singing with me forever. It's kind of like a glamorous pop. And then my band. Great piano player, great drummer, great bass players. And so if you have a kid that's at all looking up to great musicians, bring them, because they'll see the best that night. And if you've heard my records, then get ready. The live shows have nothing to do with my records. They're way more fun and more artistry and ups and downs and, you know, roller coaster, I guess.
Yes, they are spectacular. Tell us a little bit about your trumpet, because I know this is your baby.
So I've played for the last 16 years. It's a Martin Handcraft trumpet, Martin Handcraft. So it's from 1939. And it just, I don't know, you know, they didn't make that many of them, but it has the perfect resonance for me. It's a very large bore horn, so you can kind of diffuse the sound a little bit. It's a wider sound than a trumpet usually is. It's a warmer sound than a trumpet usually is. And it's been really great to me. And right now it's not fighting me at all, so I love it.
Wow. So we have a special connection with that instrument.
Yes.
Wow. It's not an easy thing to find the right instrument for yourself, right?
True.
People have no idea.
True.
Yes.
You're absolutely true.
What would you like to say to your audience here?
Well, first of all, thank you for your great interview. You're lovely. And secondly, we hope everyone comes to the show and understands it's a night of entertainment hosted by six of the greatest jazz musicians you're ever going to hear and three special guests. And it's going to be a real fun night. But no one knows when they come to a Chris BOTTI show, if they've never been, they see a trumpet player on an album cover, and they have no idea that it's run like a pop show with all these different people coming in and out. And then afterwards is where they go, oh, my God. Then they start coming back. This is our 25th time or our 200th time seeing your show. We're not doing all these things that people expect.
Mm-hmm.
So when they come and they don't expect it, and then they get hooked, and then that's what is really pleasing to me.
And then they follow you forever.
Correct.
Don't miss an evening with the one and only Chris BOTTI, and get your tickets today at njpack.org, njpack.org, or call the box office 888-466-5722, 888-466-5722. The concert is in Newark, New Jersey, NJ Pack, November 8th. Wednesday, 7:30. Chris, I can't thank you enough for being with us. I know you are extremely busy, and I'm absolutely thrilled to have you on the show. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it.
And we can't wait to see you here.
Okay.
All right. Take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
WABC.
No, I've never been premenstrual in my life.
You're not PMSing.
Not right now.
Don't believe us. Believe Yola. She's not going to lie to you.
Yeah, I never lie.
Exactly. Let's put you on the spot.
I would be like a shy mouse.
Waving through the window.
That was
yeah.
It's Yola Nash.